Hello and welcome to the 150th episode of Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall Unity Edition, Glitching Clouds and all. I am Amethyst Lunatari and... yeah, welcome. I have some news. We have this quest. That's the main quest. But there are some other quests out of Wayrest that I would like to do. And there's just one problem. I figured I'd do some quests to bump up, you know, bump up my reputation because the guards are all after me over there. And found out, well, you can raise points with the NPC you got the quest from, and then related NPCs usually only like a point or two from what I've seen. So, yeah. That would be a lot of quests. You're gonna see why in just a second. And the other way to do it is to rest. Gavin Clayton, I believe is his name, Interkarma, who, you know, created this with the help of others. Where do I have this written down? He said, every 122 days you go up a point in reputation until it goes back to zero. So, for me, that would be 4,880 days to get to zero, or 13 years of game time. Which is really difficult, especially because you can only loiter... well, loitering has a limit. You can only rest for 99 hours at a time, and you can't, like, put in that you want to rest for days. It has to be hours. Yeah, it's not going to do that. There's a console command. Print underscore legal rep. Now, I don't normally do this. This is, like, completely spoilery, and I do apologize for that. I don't do this lightly, but I want to show you guys these quests. I want to play these quests. I want you guys to see them. So zero, I think, is normal. Minevia, I'm a villain. Negative 41. That's actually the worst one, but not by much. I think that's where I came out of a residence, or I was looking for a residence. Went to go talk to somebody, and I was in steal mode, so I stole from that person. I think that's where that was. I don't remember Minevia specifically. So here's Wayrest. I'm a criminal. Negative 40. I'm zero in everything else. So in order to get this 40 points put back to zero, I don't know if it needs to be zero. I think like negative 10 is like they're watching out for you or something. I'm not sure. But yeah, it would take me 4,880 days to make this zero like the others. So then I could definitely be able to do Prince Helseth's quest. But he won't even talk to me. And at this point, people in Wayrest won't even talk to me. Like, if you go up and, you know, ask them where someone is or where something is, you can't even get that. It just says, you get no response. So, I've made them very angry. So, I have two choices. I was thinking about putting this up to a vote, but, well, we're kind of running out of time because at the time you are watching this, if you're watching this the day it came out, well, I played this the day before it came out. So that's how much we run out of backlog on our videos. So I was going to put it, thinking of putting it to a vote, a poll, or something like that, but it just isn't time. You know, the 150th episode would end up being delayed because of that, which wouldn't be the end of the world, but I just decided to do this, and again, not something I do lightly. I don't think I'm ever going to be back to Menevia again. This is the command. I can't see what I'm typing, but it's clear underscore negative legal rep. Oh! See, I can't see what I'm typing. Clear, because my recording indicator is over this. It's an overlay that just hangs out in the bottom left corner, so it's covering this. Right, so we cleared negative legal reputation for Wayrest and Menevia. Who cares about Menevia? So, I'm glad it was only those two, because I don't know if there's a way to change specifically. I really just wanted to change Wayrest, because who cares about Menevia? So now, well, there's Menevia. Common citizen. Well, it's easier to find it because there are only two things that didn't have zero. Now I'm looking Wayrest. I am a common citizen. So I do apologize for that. I hope you guys don't mind overly much, but the other option for me would have been waiting 13 years in-game, or doing like 20 quests or something, which I don't even know if you can get that many out of the Wayrest Palace. So, yeah, so there's definitely a case to be made why I should not have done that, but on the plus side, we get to do these little side quests. They're like offshoots of the main quest. So I figured it'd be kind of interesting. I mean, who wouldn't want to see what, you know, Prince Helseth wants me to be up to, so. A little practice. Okay. Okay. So we should not be in any trouble once we arrive. I mean, I don't care about dodging guards and this and that. You know, just make clear about that. Because I was dodging them. Like, a while back, I was dodging these guards. But I could go in the palace and still get quests. Now I can't even do that, so. Wait. I'm in Daggerfall, right? Yeah, let's just go to the bank first. I have a lot of money. Honey. It's this way, right? Heading south, yeah. But I don't have to get my weapons repaired. I've already done that. I just gotta deposit this money. And then I gotta figure out what's going on with my cart, because I have a lot of, like, alchemy ingredients, I guess it would be. So even with the gold taken out, there's a lot of weight in the wagon right now. Little jump. It's next to the sprint button. Ew, loaves of fish. Where am I? Am I there? I am there. It's this building. Okay. It's very inconvenient having a door open that way. Alright, so I have just over 10,000 gold pieces. And in the wagon, we have 16,000. Now we are going to need some money for traveling around here and there. So I'm just going to put 25,000 in the bank. And it should automatically take it out of the cart as well. I have 326,855 gold in my account. Okay, so now I can carry plenty. Almost 40 pounds? Kilos? I'm not sure. I think it's pounds. And then my wagon still can only carry a little over 100. So it's way down with all this stuff. This stuff creeps up on you when you've got like 43 mummy wrappings and stuff like that. So I gotta figure out what I'm doing with that, but I really do not want to be doing that right now. I want to go embark on a quest. Alright, so now we're gonna save and restart the recording, because when I'm ducking down because I stopped the recording. Don't look at me like that. When we travel to new places, sometimes we crash, and sometimes it fully crashes me to where I just have like a blank screen on the monitor. And then the recording is screwed up. I still don't have enough gold. Didn't I leave myself 1,000? 25,000? Did I mess up? Maybe it's all on the horse, then. A wagon, rather. Oh, yeah. Alright. So when you're traveling, it doesn't take the money out of the cart, okay? Availabith. Yet in the bank it does that, so. Alright, finally. Well, I'm still in Daggerfall. Construction improved. See a statue with a plaque that reads Saint Lysin Garfield of Wayrest. The rest of the plaque gives a description of her life. Well, I want to read the description. Alright, so we are at this time. Oops. Destruction 50%. Nice. Halfway there. It helps when you actually use it. You know, it's just, I run out of mana. Excuse me. I tend to run out of mana, and then I don't have for healing, so that's why I tend to heal more. I'm surprised my restoration goes up as slow as it does. Probably because I'm using a lower level healing spell. I'm just trying to save on mana. And yeah, the game didn't crash. Awesome. Very happy about the no crashings. So now Prince Helseth should respond to us. I don't even know. Keep in mind, guys, I'm still playing blind. I just know some gameplay things about the reputation now. And I know that Prince Helseth has a quest. I don't know what the quest is. I used to know the name of the quest, but I've forgotten. So, I'm still playing blind. Don't worry about that. I just happened to find out my reputation was completely horrible, and that I most probably could not do that quest or the ones coming after. I know there's like a couple after that. Two, I would say. Maybe three. They're still coming after me. I'm still a common citizen. I pacified a battle mage. Hopefully he'll answer me now. Oh, he still won't answer. You know, it must be... checking it again. That's incredibly unfortunate. Well, that's the legal rep. I must be a lower reputation with the castle. He'll talk to me, but he has no quests. Fellow members of the Mages Guild have to stick together. No response. Well met. Alright, I'm getting damaged. Hold on. Thank you. Alright, now that I have left, let me check again. I know it doesn't look like it moved because it's just printing the same thing. I'm still a common citizen. Okay. So that's my legal reputation. Oh. How do I scroll through this? Print legal rep. There's gonna be another rep, right? For the castle? The NPCs? I can barely see what I'm doing. NPC rep? No. Okay. Alright, I'll be right back. Okay, I figured it out. He still didn't respond right away, but what it is I cleared my legal rep, which I didn't even care to do. I mean, maybe it affects things in here, I'm not sure. But Prince Helseth and the other NPCs inside belong to a factional reputation. So as far as I know, there's no way to clear your factional reputation. But there is something else I can do. And let's get pummeled by these guys. Oh yeah, feels great. Let's just see if he'll... I'm clicking. It took me a couple times clicking. Yeah, never mind. Okay, we gotta do this. Mod NPC rep. And then with, you can go negative 100. Why would you do that? To 100. What if I just make it 0? Is that... Okay. My NPC rep for Prince Helseth has 0. He's not answering. I got a lot of people gathered around here. Maybe because I'm currently being attacked. You know what I did? Hold up. Shh. Don't tell him I'm in here. I'm invisible. Are you attacking? Oh, they're blocking the door. Ouch. Pretty good healing. You're attacking your friend? There's nobody here, nobody around here at all. Yeah, I'm clicking. Not very pleasant to look at, is he? Alright. Mod NPC. Yeah, I was messing around with all this stuff. Okay. Mod NPC rep 0. He didn't respond right away before, but I don't want to make it like excellent. Does it even make a difference? I mean, if your reputation is... I don't want to just automatically put it to 100. I don't know what I should put it to. I don't want to get like end up getting more rewards for a quest and cheating that way. I mean, I don't even know if that would happen. Oh. Oh, 50 here. I clicked him a few times and he... Okay, does it have to be 100? Keeps going to this one. 100. Alright, 100... Trying to figure out how he responded to me that one time. You like me now. I think he wasn't answering before because... Should I leave and come back in? Oh, I'm losing my invisibility. Maybe once I'm visible, he'll answer me. Come on! I should've just... I swear, this guy answered me. He started giving me a quest, yes or no. I told him no, I didn't even read it, and I load it up. I don't have the mana right now to cast that spell. So maybe he doesn't answer me because I'm invisible, but... Ah! Maybe we have to go out, come back in, it has to reload everything, I don't know. I need a courier, Persephone, but no common jelly-armed, gas-headed pox of a mercenary will do. I have a letter of utmost importance to be delivered to a high dignitary who will be defended against unwelcome intrusion. In return for this, I will not only reward you with a short bow, but also put in a positive word for you with the King and Queen of Rayrest. But I will give you some information on the affair with Daggerfall I hope you would receive elsewhere. Does this sound like an agreeable arrangement? He wants me to deliver a letter. And he's going to give me a short bow. Yes. Excellent. Meet me here this time tomorrow and I will give you the letter and the name and location of the recipient. Hopefully you'll answer me then. Alright, let's go. They seek our death. Alright, throw in a save here. So I just have to come back here tomorrow and hope he'll answer me. Blackmailing Prince Helseth. Prince Helseth wants me to meet him tomorrow at the castle for the details of a quest. I will be acting as a courier. Well, if I blackmail him, he's really going to be unhappy. Maybe it means blackmailing is, you know... Is he the nice Prince Helseth, or is he the blackmailing Prince Helseth? Oh, he's the blackmailing kind. No, I don't think it means that. Okay. West is the Red Wolf. Let's go stay at the Red Wolf. I'm gonna get back this mana anyway. I probably will run in there invisible again. So he wants it 10 a.m. Oh, interesting with the stairs right there. Hi. This is a pretty interesting looking place. I've seen one like this. Look at that. You can look down and everyone just stares up at you. Ta-da! Alright, my good man. Now I feel kind of funny about that I totally cleared my negative legal rap when I didn't need to. Look at that. Look at the floor, that's nice. Kills me how you can get arrested and or killed by guards for stealing, taking something from a wardrobe in your own hotel room. Alright, so... this will make it an early day. For a while. How about 22 hours? Dodging improved, yeah. Dodging all these crazies in the palace, 44%. And 73% to the next level. Pretty awesome. Good day to you. Maybe do something else for a while instead of staring at people. Oh, that was west. Yeah, east. Back to Prince Helseth. We'll see if I can talk to him with the invisibility on. So I would... I feel kind of funny doing that. Like, I would change the rep back. I guess I could by just killing people, right? I don't know. I'll leave that up to you guys. What do you think? It probably doesn't even matter. You guys want me to change the rep back to 40? Or 40, around 40, I'll just kill an NPC or two in here, and that should do it. Or maybe a few. Maybe it's negative 10 per NPC. I don't know. So what do you guys think? Should I just keep the negative legal rep at 0 here in Wayrest? Or should I change it back? Because what I did with that was change it back to 0, but that did not affect the palace inside. So I did it for nothing, really. So, yeah, leave your comments, let me know if you'd like me to change it back. I'll stand on a rooftop and shoot some arrows into a couple of civilians and we'll see how it changes. Yeah, it takes a lot. Nice not to be chased as soon as you get into the place. Let's see if he'll answer us. I think because I'm invisible. That's all because they caught me going back there to steal the painting from Wayrest. Can I close these? Alright. This way I'll turn visible, I'll only have this person attacking. Unless they start opening doors. I wish you would answer me. You know I'm here. This is the agreed upon time. Well, it was like 10-ish or something. Does this guy answer? He does. Alright. As soon as that one starts moving. Yo! Come on. I'm here! Try and leave and come back. It worked before loading up. Ouch. Alright, let's come back in. Pardon me. He won't talk to me again. Yeah, these were the things I tried to do. Print the factional rep. There's no such command. And it wasn't in a listing. If you type in help, it gives you a list of all of them. Crime committed is interesting. It just tells me none. Yo, answer me. I'm getting demolished here. Oh, I took out my sword. Maybe that's not a valid rep or something. Alright, I wanted to sheathe my sword. I'm about to die. I'm gonna die now. Maybe it's too early? Wait, what'd I do? Spell effect failed. Oh, antidote. Well, it never expires. Let's just loiter for an hour. See, maybe that's it? Yeah, it definitely was. Because when I was at the inn, it was 10:20. Ah, hello again, Persephone. Here is the letter. It is to be given to Lord Castellian, the head of the Elder Council, who is currently at his house, the Kingfield residence in Kinghart Palace. I need the letter delivered and you back here. Like I mentioned before, Lord Castellian values his privacy to an excess. Be prepared for some resistance at your arrival in the Kingfield residence. I would ask that you not read the letter, as it is private correspondence. If word of its contents gets out, I will blame you. Okay. Door. Oh, good God. Step aside, boy. Ouch. Prince Helseth wants me to deliver a letter to Lord Castellian, leader of the Elder Council of Wayres, in his holiday manor, the Kingfield residence in Kinghart Palace. I have to deliver the letter and return. Oh, we don't even have to rest. We can just fast travel over there. But now I am going to do something that's... I know it's cheating, but we have to know, don't we? Sorry, if I got cut off when I'm saving and stuff, that's what happens. Okay. So I'm gonna restore after reading this. My dear Lord Castellian, sorry about the necessity of delivering this letter by the roughest possible service, I beg your pardon, but it would be unthinkable to approach you at the castle on such a delicate matter. I have long admired your loyalty to the crown and neutrality in internal affairs. Understand that I only want to save your dignity from a possibly embarrassing scenario. The problem rests in your sister, the Lady Pacifa, who, though she resides abroad, still communicates regularly with members of court. I understand and respect the depth of your sibling love and affection for one another, for in response to a curious inquiry of mine, Lady Pacifa sent me several touching letters penned in your hand. Have you ever espied with delight a red berry half drowned in cream? So I dreamed of you, my dearest love, pouring my soul into you. Sweet for your touch, dear, my soul is quite forfeit. Oh, yeah. Sent to Helseth, okay. While you and I know the innocence of your fondness for the lady, the more prurient minds at court, as you are aware, are inclined toward grotesque misinterpretation. Her husband, I understand, is famous for his jealous rages. I am of several minds on the matter how to best avoid possible negative reaction, and would appreciate your response at the soonest possible opportunity. I will await you at Castle Wayrest. Helseth, Prince of Wayrest. Okay. Well, maybe it's not. Maybe it would not be a misinterpretation. It seems clear to me. I don't know. Definitely doesn't seem like just friends or something. Okay. So, we're going to travel there. I'm just going to restart the recording really quick. Alright, King Heart Palace. Restoration and illusion improved. A guard dog tied to a post barks at you as you pass by. I bark back. You come across someone carrying some glass bottles in a satchel bag, a traveling alchemist, perhaps? Yes, yes, perhaps. Oh. Orc strength, nah. Shadow form, nah. I have them as spells, okay. Okay, so it's... Oh, so maybe she was blackmailing him then. Trying to blackmail him. Lord Castellian. Kingfield Resonance. By the Dark Lord, it's you! Mark it on my map. Thank you. Oh, it's like this. All right, ready? Said I might reap resistance or something. Someone calls out, "Come in." Borbausa? Better be good. I'm busy. Oh. Got anyone in through here, Borbausa? Would I find the resistance in this house, or just outside? Jeez, these doors are... There's just a lot of them. Lord Castellian! You wait while Lord Castellian reads the letter. His skin grows pale, and his hand begins to shake. I see. Please wait while I pen a response to Prince Helseth. It only takes him a minute to write the response, which he then hands to you. Alright, I guess then we were just returning. Now we're gonna use our special... We never read this spell. Just called Load. Princess Ellis... Wait. My good friend Lord Woodborn says you are a hero that can be trusted. I would be truly indebted to you if you would stop by some time to chat. Maybe you could even do something for me. I would be oh so grateful. Mm. I think we want to talk to someone else before that. So what's this saying? Prince Helseth, I appreciate your kindness and I will meet with you very shortly at your convenience. Casting our unread spell. That's just me. That I didn't have to do. It's just... we have to know, you know? I gotta read all the things. You know how it is. That went through the house. Okay, keep going through the house here. I don't want to hit people. Okay, back to Wayrest. Adventurers! Hello there, it's a beautiful day, isn't it? Are you perhaps an adventurer too? What's your name, stranger? A lot of... oh. Is this what... I was like, what's all the noise? Someone has set up an attraction nearby, gathering a small crowd together to try to hit a ball with a large wooden club. Never heard of that pastime. A few people make the attempt and all fail. The owner shouts that whoever can hit the ball further than 10 meters will win 280 gold pieces. Will you try it? Hell yeah. What seemed like a simple game becomes complex once the club touches your hand. Its odd weight and shape make a solid hit very difficult. The gamesman tosses the ball 5 times, eliciting 5 misses. While you fail to earn the prize, the only penalty you suffer is the mockery of the small crowd that stopped to watch you. Surely some more practice with clubs and hammers will prepare you for a rematch. Oh. How dare you laugh at me! I'll kill you all! Yeah, I guess we need a better, like, blunt weapon skill to do well in baseball. Oh good, we're nearby. Look at these sunflowers all lined up perfectly. So, I think if he's invisible, I think if I'm invisible, he'll still answer me. Because Lord Darkworth would. Wait, where am I? Oh. The thing's over here. Yeah, it was a lot of work to get this working right. Stand by, guys. I'll be right back. Alright, ready? Should I make myself invisible? Sure. Make it a little less chaotic. And hopefully he will answer me. Well done, Persephone. Your budding reputation appears to be deserved. Lord Castellian is quite pliable now. Yeah, my budding reputation is artificially enhanced. Anyway, here's the short bow I promised. Never let it be said that Prince Helseth is not a man of his bond. Your word is your bond, and your bond is your word. Oh yes, I promised to tell you something of the situation in Daggerfall. I suspect my family has more to do with it than is commonly known. We sent advisors to urge King Lysandus and King Cameron to mend their differences on the eve of the Battle of Cringane Field. Lysandus was disgustingly loyal to the Emperor, while Cameron was fighting for more autonomy. According to the advisor's report, they arrived too late because they were waylaid by the orcs of Gortwog en route. However, I have heard stories that at least some of our advisors arrived at Lysandus' tent and spoke to him briefly. At this time, I cannot say more. If I receive more information or if the situation progresses, I will certainly send you word. Oh, and we got this short bow, which I will identify later. Alright, so now I think we can do a quest for Barenziah? I have to do this again? I don't know how... I mean, arrow up should give you the last thing typed in. Again, just doing this so that she'll talk to me. I think we have to leave and come back. Reloaded. Do I have to be visible? So it seems to be... Yes, Persephone? Our stars seem to be rising in syndesis. What would you need? What does that mean? Syndesis. Yo, Barenziah. That's a Lord Woodbone. Maybe I need a letter from her first? Up arrow. Yeah, it doesn't work. Down arrow. Trying to only do this when necessary. Maybe she'll talk to me once I turn visible? Don't be spanking me. Not in the mood right now. She won't speak. Jesus. Let's go rest and come back. Is this the inn or one of the inns? One day, I'll take it. Get some restoration. About 24 hours. Time for the room has expired. Medical increased. Don't send people after me. I asked for a day and I stayed for 24 hours. Is that dog? I heard some kind of sound. Medical. Oh, illusion 7%. Medical 23% and restoration 46%. Sweet. Ah! A page wearing the colors and pale yellow rose of Wayrest appears silently at your side. He hands you a letter and disappears as quietly as he arrived. Eh, not after me. Hopefully this is a letter from... What's your name? Who I just tried to talk to. Barenziah. Alright, so we can talk to her right away. We need a letter from her first. Castle Wayrest. Dear Persephone, my beloved son has brought your name to my attention and suggested that we might have some business to discuss. I understand that we have a mutual interest. Please visit me at Castle Wayrest at your earliest possible convenience. Yours, Barenziah, Queen of the Kingdom of Wayrest. Okay, awesome. So we're waiting for a letter. Once again, guys, I'm playing blind. I just know the quests involved and some of the order that they need to be done in. And I just know we need to talk to Barenziah before we talk to Elisana. That's about all I know. Because I do want to do her quest as well. She's on the side, like as you walk into the dining area. She's just standing right there. And that's... Oh wow, we're heading south. What the hell? How'd I get so turned around? Alright, well... Northwest. Sorry guys. About all this icy water here, it's terribly inconvenient. Should I try to talk to her invisible? I'm still not completely. I mean, I think you can talk to him while invisible. I think it's only for other reasons that they haven't been answering. Thank you for responding to my letter, Persephone. It is very difficult for a queen of a powerful nation and a queen whose home is far away to trust any mercenary. That's why when my dear child Helseth told me about you, right? So we have to help him first. I was so quick to write. There is a rather sensitive situation brewing and I need someone I can trust to correct some wayward revolutionaries. For 966 gold pieces, will you perform such a service for me? I am also prepared to reward you with information as well as 966 gold. Yeah, I just couldn't pass up these quests, guys. That's especially this one. Yes, I'm glad to hear it. Some years ago, a disgruntled and possibly deranged scribe of mine wrote a biography of me which my worst enemy would call cruel and defamatory, because the book was also excessively critical of the Empire and Septim Imperial family. It was wisely suppressed and its author executed. Oh boy. Unfortunately, chapters of the book resurface from time to time. I have reason to believe one chapter of the book has been purchased by the orcs of Orsinium, who are attempting to publish it. I need it removed from their stronghold, also named Orsinium. Time is of the essence. I'm sure Gartwag will not wait long. Once the chapter is safe, we will talk further about your ambitions. I think I know what kind of book this is, because I've read that book. In, Skyrim. Okay. I will leave post-haste. Alright. Barenziah's book. Queen Barenziah has hired me to find a chapter of a libelous book about her that has been circulating around the bay. She believes it to be in the dungeons of Orsinium, home of the orc warlord Gortwag. Now, we've been to Orsinium already, so this shouldn't be a big deal. I'm still invisible. Okay. Alright. Making all my preparations. So we don't have a... We don't have a... something to click in either of them. Orsinium area. You notice orc tracks. Orcs have trampled the ground here. That would explain the tracks. We've been here not too long ago for the Orcish Emancipation Quest. Oh. Hi. I've killed everyone in here and I've returned to kill you. Nope. So, Medora wants the dust of restful death. Only because I respect the memory of King Lysandus will I do this. Oh. The dust can be found in ruins of Master Ford's guard on her own island. Tell Medora that the price is her support of my claim to the heart. She'll know what it means. Okay, it's not why we came here, but that's for the other quest. Medora wants the dust of restful death. Ruins of Master Ford's guard on her own island. The price is her support of my claim to her to the heart. Alright, hopefully he'll also answer me about Barenziah's book. Hmm. Should we leave and come back in? Oh, no. Yeah, I've come here for something else. Alright, so I'm just reading up on this. Medora came to me in a vision and told me that Lysandus' ghost could be soothed if I can convince Gortwag, Lord of the Orcs in Orsinium, to tell me where it is. I have spoken with Gortwag. He claims that the dust of restful death can be found in ruins of Masterford's guard on the Isle of Balfiera. He also instructed me to tell Medora that she must support his claim to the heart of Tiber Septim, whatever that is. Oh, he didn't say Heart of Tiber Septim, he just said Heart. She must support his claim to the Heart of Tiber Septim. You will never have it, you monster. He won't answer me until... Because I have two things for him. Okay, I just have to find the book. I don't talk to him. Well, this is a huge place. I don't know if this stuff came back. I didn't hear a... Oops. It's not here. Yeah, I hear a Daedra. Well, that sounded like an orc. Maybe that's it. Maybe he doesn't answer. Maybe you just have to find the book in here. I wonder if any of the baddies have been repopulated. Okay, I remember that being one way to go. And then... Which way is back? Here's the main chamber. Went up here. I think it's this way. Hopefully I didn't come from this way. No, going up. Looking for a secret door, but I guess I would have found it the first time I was here. Alright. Our way is clear. I'm gonna go this way. There were some baddies I remember in here, I think, that came back. Yeah, I hear that. I do hear that. Big central chamber. And this is the way we just came, right? I think. Up here. Because I want to mark it. But I'm not completely sure as this is where we came in. It goes up and around. Up here. Yeah, I don't know. I hear a giant. Oh, and I didn't set a teleport thing. I mean, it's fine. Just run back, but... can't believe I barely... went. Okay. This goes up here. That's gotta be it, right? Let's just see. This goes back to that, like, dining hall type place. Yeah. Alright, so I'll set... I could have set it back there, but let's set it teleport here. Or a recall, rather. Mark. Okay. We are set here. Look at that skull on top. Oh! Clicking the skull teleported me up here. I did not know that would happen. Back down, and I think the easiest way to do that is just to go like that. Ah. So that skull sent me over there. This one doesn't have a skull. Oh! I didn't click on anything, I just stood there. Well, that's tricky. There's no doors along here, so... Alright, so this... is where the mark is put. I'm just gonna mark it. So I know which door to not go through. So, definitely nothing like a book around here. We have this door. We have a door on all four sides. So let's try the west door. Okay, done. The east door is our mark. This looks like a self-contained area. Let's go through the north door, and then the south will be the last one left. I hope I'm not on a wild goose chase, because she told me... I thought she told me to talk to him. She said to move faster. He will have moved on to other things or something. I hate these. Because enemies, you just hide. Alright. There's another room around the corner here that it might be in. Straight ahead. Not seeing it. There's only one way up or down. That's from the ramp over here. Kinda glad all the enemies didn't respawn. I have a feeling I'm going to randomly run into one and it's going to scare the crap out of me because I'm not going to be prepared for it. I'll be in a state of false complacency. That's what the box is. Alright. That was the north door. Now we just have the south door. They're like a mummy or a zombie or something. I have to rest. Well, we need to head south. It's really just... enemies. Hopefully I didn't screw myself. I really just wanted my stamina back up, really. Oh! Some action! You guys might have wanted some of that. A white poppy. He was just hiding in here. Right, so I've looked in here and here, yeah. So, quite a bit of caves or tunnels this way. I'll try down here. Have you seen something of a very old book? Why put that there if we can't open it? Okay, we haven't tried here. Secret door. But nothing. I was just here. How to get back to where I was? I want to get back up here somewhere. Ramp. You turn this way, right? Yeah, that's the way back. That sounds like a Daedra. But I think sometimes the orcs make that sound. Alright, so we came from here. So we've eliminated the left. If you go forward, there's a whole bunch of crap. Let's go right first. Click. Forward is a dead end. Liquidy. All right, so that's forward. Try left, I guess. Starting to not be sure where to go. I think we just saw that from above. I don't know. What if he is supposed to just give it to us or something? And she told us to be quick. Otherwise he would have gotten rid of the book or something. So we're wasting time maybe then doing this. But he wouldn't answer me. Whoops. Thank you. Think it could be here underwater? I mean, in that case, it'd be all waterlogged. Oh, I clicked on the bed! And it asked me why I wanted to sleep. Yeah, it's not a good bed for sleeping, I'm afraid. What if it is underwater, right? Oops. Oh god. down. Up. What am I doing? That's the up button. Why did I cast a spell doing that? I don't see it here. This orc's gonna jump out and scare the crap out of me. If it does, watch your headphones. Do not let me deafen you, please. I won't be able to control myself. Alright, so down here is... I think we've been down there. Yeah, that's... That goes down and then up this steep incline hill. Ends in these... rooms. Hopefully I've explored that. I'm not completely sure. Oh, I did go down here. All right. Stand by, guys. Okie dokie. Yeah, I cheat again. I don't know where to find this thing. Or if I was supposed to be searching in the dungeon for it, not talking to Gortwog, and that his... I thought maybe his dialogue about Medora messed everything up, that he would only talk to me. Maybe he would talk to me again once I finished Medora's quest. Which is the dust of restful death, I believe. But yeah, I don't think that's the case. We're supposed to find it in here. And... I can recall back. Alright, can we rest? Running skill improved. Yeah, I've been running all over the place. Running, 44%. Surprised that's not higher. Okay. So I did quickly check a walkthrough. And these lock 128 down here that we've seen before. We have to open it. Now I cannot open it at my current lock picking level or even the open spell, but there's another way to do it. We will levitate. There's another way up there. You gotta click something. Actually, I found out. You click this skull, it brings you up there. Okay. Now I think it's up here. We need a lever. completely sure where it is. But it unlocks those doors. There's the Night Mother. Okay, no lever in here. I just looked at it quickly, because I don't like cheating like that. Unfortunately, I might have to look again. I don't think there's going to be an... I turned back into this, though. Da-loom. Da-loom. I was under the impression it was close by. Maybe it's the other way. Because why would it be all the way in the middle of nowhere when it unlocks those doors? Oh, I didn't set a mark again. Which way? Oh, yeah. Right ahead, I think. I mean, maybe the levers right up here? I don't see anything like a lever. Weird, this cage, though. Unless the lever's along the top? I wonder if he's down there. We're gonna have to fight him. That didn't move. Ah! That! Gotta be that. This way? I think? Yes. Okay. So now we need to levitate down there. Be that he's been released. Rise. Doors open. Ah, here we are. Let me grab that last. I just want to see what's in the other rooms. Those can be full of monsters. I can't go any faster because I'm levitating. Now I think that these levers just open the way. Open that back up. Befitting a queen and a ceremonial departure from the... Alright. Found the bottom here. Okay. Befitting a queen and a ceremonial departure from the gates of Imperial City. Chapter 6. You dance on the edge of a volcano, child. Drellian scolded as Barenziah admired the emerald ring her lover had given her to celebrate their one-month anniversary. "How so? We make one another happy. We harm no one. Symmachus bade me to be discriminate and discreet. Who better could I choose? And we've been most discreet. He treats me as a daughter in public. Tiber Septim's nightly visits were made through a secret passage. He slavers over you like a dog his dinner. Have you not noticed the coolness of the Empress and her son toward you?" Barenziah shrugged. Even before she and Septim had become lovers, she had no more from his family than bare civility. Threadbare civility. "What matter? It is Tiber who holds power. It is his son who holds the future. Do not hold his mother up to public scorn, I beg you." "Can I help it if that dry stick of a woman cannot hold her husband's interest even in conversation at dinner?" "Have less to say in public, that's all I ask. She matters little, save that her children love her and you do not want them as enemies. Tiber Septim is not long to live. I mean..." Jolene amended quickly at Barenziah's scowl. "Humans are all short-lived. Temporary, as we elves say. They come and go as the seasons do, but the families of the powerful live on for a time. You must be a family friend if you would see lasting profit from your relationship." "Ah, how can I make you truly see, you who are so young and human-bred as well? If you take care, you and Mournhold are like to live to see the fall of Septim's dynasty, if indeed he has founded one. As you have seen its rise, it is the way of human history. They ebb and flow like the tides. Their cities and even their empires bloom like spring flowers, only to wither and die in the summer sun." Barenziah just laughed. She knew that rumors abounded about her and Tiber Septim. She enjoyed the attention for all save the Empress, and her son seemed captivated by her. Bards sang of her dark beauty and her charming ways. She was in fashion and in love. And if it was temporary, well, what was not? She was happy for the first time she could remember, each day filled with joy and pleasure, and the nights get yet better. "What is wrong with me?" Barenziah lamented. "Look, not one of my skirts fit. What's become of my waist? Am I getting fat?" Barenziah regarded her thin arms and legs and her undeniably thickened waist in the mirror with displeasure. Drellian shrugged. "You appear to be with child, young as you are. Constant pairing with a human has brought you early to fertility. I see no choice but for you to speak with him about it. You are in his power. It would be best, I think, for you to go directly to Mournhold if he will agree, and bear the child there." "Alone?" Barenziah placed her hands on her swollen belly, tears forming in her eyes. Everything in her yearned to share the fruit of her love with her lover. "He'll never agree to that. He won't be parted from me now. You'll see." Drellian shook her gray head. Although she said no more, a look of sympathy and sorrow had replaced her usual cool scorn. That night, Barenziah told Tiber Septim of it when he came to her. Okay, this is a book-length letter. "With child?" He looked shocked. "Stunned. You sure of it? I was told elves do not bear so young." Barenziah smiled uneasily. "How can I be sure? I'll fetch my healer." The healer, a high elf of middle years, confirmed that Barenziah was indeed pregnant and that such a thing had never before been known to happen. "It was a testimony to His Excellency's potency," the healer said sycophantically. Tiber Septim snarled at him. "This must not be," he said. "Undo it." "Sire," the healer gaped at him. "I cannot." "Of course you can," he snapped. "I command you do so." Barenziah, wide-eyed with sudden terror, sat up in the bed. "No," she screamed. "No, what are you saying?" "My dear child," Tiber Septim sat down beside her with his winning smile. "I'm so sorry, truly, but this cannot be. Your child could be a threat to my son and his sons. I will put it no more plainly than that." "The child I bear is your child," she wailed. "No, it's but a possibility, a might be, not yet gifted with a soul or quickened into life. I will not have it so." He gave the healer another hard stare, and the elf began to tremble. "It is her child. Children are few among elves. No woman conceives more than four, and that is very rare. Two is the allotted number. Some bear none, some only one. If I take this one from her, she may not conceive again." "You told me she would not bear to me. I have little faith in your prognostications." Barenziah scrambled naked from her bed and ran for the door, not knowing where she was going, only that she could not stay. She never reached the door, for blackness took her. Barenziah awoke to pain and emptiness. Drellyane was there to soothe the pain and clean the blood that pooled under her legs, but there was nothing to fill the emptiness. Tiber Septim sent gifts and flowers and came for short visits, always well attended. Barenziah received these visits with pleasure, but he came no more at night, nor did she wish for him. After a month, when she was physically recovered, it was announced that Symmachus had requested she come to Mournhold earlier than planned, and that she would leave forthwith. She was given a splendid retinue, a wardrobe befitting a queen, and a ceremonial departure from the gates of Imperial City. Odd. So they gave her... It was an involuntary abortion. That's horrible. Alright, I'm trying to run. Still teleporting. And I think it's building this. Whoops. And four. Oh, it never mind. I had already raised it, now I lowered it. So I think, wait. Right, this is the way we go. Unfortunately, I didn't leave a mark. I'm used to, like, leaving a mark, or what was it called? Bind point. And it just, that stays the bind point until you change it. I'm not used to, still not used to. We'll be able to run quicker once this runs out. I'm still not used to it being how it disappears. Yeah, I'm just going forward. Pretty sure. So we have it. It's not a book either, it's a manuscript for a book. I look forward to returning to Barenziah. She didn't tell us not to read it, so hopefully she won't be cross with us. Oh. He's a most imposing figure, is he not? Alright, little practice. Wow. I haven't crashed at all. What, last time it kept happening. I have... Those are files you guys didn't get to see, because crashed so bad that I could not stop the recording. I had to reset the computer, and so the file was corrupted or not finished correctly. You come across someone picking some twigs, a traveling alchemist maybe? God. You're not a traveling alchemist. I love how they always... Not always, but they often have, like, one more. Is that the palace? Or it's... Yeah. It is nice not to have guards chasing me, but let me know if you guys want me to destroy my reputation with Ray Rest again. I'll gladly do so. They just chase me through here until I get into the palace. It could probably affect my faction with these people as well. But I can just target the NPC I want and increase my reputation with that one NPC. I hit save, didn't I? Okay. Nobody here. Nobody at all. Very well done, Persephone. Prince Helseth, what? Prince Helseth did not exaggerate your virtues. Here is the 966 gold pieces I promised. Right, and she also had information. She's not giving me any. Could have sworn she said she would give me information. Persephone, sometimes I don't know why I continue to sustain some of these cities. The guards in Vanlek Court are apparently not competent enough to stop a criminal uprising. Now I get reports of nightly assaults in the streets. Go there and do what the town guard refuses. I've already done something very similar to that. Might as well order some mead then. Let the whole thing burn. Alright. I think we're talking to Elisana next, who's down there. So before my invisibility wears off, I'll call this an episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.